In this video, we are going to find the sum of this series. How to solve it? First, we can use a summing notation. So here, just sum k from 1 to infinity. Then the numerator is k. Then the bottom, k plus 1 factorial. So then for this infinite sum, we can write as here. The sum k from 1 to n. Then here, we use the limit. At n goes to infinity. Then the next step, we can rewrite this fraction. We can rewrite it as a difference of two sums, difference of two fractions. So we can put it as a 1 over k factorial, then minus 1 over k plus 1 factorial. So this is an important part of this solution. So it's really easy to check it. They are equivalent. So probably it's easier to go from here to here. Just do the common denominator, then simplify, so you get here. Now let's expand this sum. So when k is 1, so here's a 1, here's a 2. So then we have 1 minus 1 over 2 factorial. Then k is a 2, so this is a 2, this is a 3. So here we have 2 factorial. Then here, 3 factorial. Then the next one, here's 3 factorial, here, 4 factorial. Then keep going until the last term. The last term, that's a case n. So here's n, here's n plus 1. So then here's this is the last term. Okay, so now let's see. Starting from the second term, you see they have this is a negative, this is a positive. So these two just cancel out. So that means starting from the second term, the two adjacent terms can cancel out. Here, and this one cancel out with a 1 right after it. So then this one cancel out with a 1 before it. So then the only terms left, that's the first term and the last term. So that's why here we have the limit and goes to infinity. Then just 1 minus the last term. Then as n goes to infinity, this term goes to 0. So then the answer is 1. Thanks for watching. See you next time.